I remember realizing how much I had in my life that wasn't essential. I also remember getting rid of it all. Well, most of it. I haven't owned a toothbrush or toothpaste in 1.5 years. I just mix baking soda with lavender oil and use that on my finger. I dip my finger in rubbing alcohol beforehand, of course. When I'm on my period, I don't use pads or tampons, I just let it flow. I stopped wearing deodorant completely about 4 years ago when I found out that inhaling your own natural body odor can actually boost your immune system. I also don't use a towel to dry off after a shower, I just let myself air dry. And since I started doing that, my skin hasn't felt dry like it usually would, which means I no longer need to use moisturizer either. I guess you could say I've made it quite far in the pursuit of owning less things. Okay, that's not totally true. Well, not totally true. The deodorant part is at least half true. But please don't brush your teeth with lavender oil or use your finger. Only if it's an emergency. The finger, not the lavender. Whatever. Now, minimalism, to me, isn't necessarily only about having less in life, but rather having less of what I find to be unnecessary and what isn't good for my physical and mental health, as well as the health of the earth, and to rather have more of what I appreciate, love, and care for. And this doesn't just go for stuff, but rather for everything, from clothes to work to relationships. I just want a life of quality. And now all of that's up for each person to define for themselves. Isn't that what we all want? You know when you open up a drawer and it's filled with things that you haven't used or even remember that you have? You know when you open up your closet and you can't find either of the only 3 sweaters that you use because they're hidden somewhere underneath the mess of all the stuff that you haven't used in years? How about when you take a look at the people that you surround yourself with and realize that some of them don't add any value to your life, but rather take from it? Or when you scroll through the contacts on your phone, only to realize that the majority are just names of people you haven't spoken to in years, and that the number of people you would actually call and share something personal with can be counted on one hand. That right there counts as clutter too. See, I used to not really think twice when it came to most of my daily decisions in life. A cute dress, I bought it. A project that seemed like fun, I jumped on it. Bright blue colored candy that barely looked edible sounded yummy. Det var liksom inte genomtänkt, as we say in Swedish. And so, I found myself being surrounded with things that I didn't really value. And when you don't value something, you don't really care to nourish it. And then it's just left there to collect dust, break, fade, or stop working. Whether that is a friendship or a pair of jeans. And it becomes a vicious cycle of living a disposable lifestyle or throwaway lifestyle, whatever you wish to call it. Now, of course, even the things that you love can fade or break. It happens all the time. But if you do value something, you don't want the reason you lose it to be because you didn't care for it enough. So the more I looked into the health aspect of a lot of the physical things that I owned, the more interested I got in sustainability. I started learning about the detriment to the environment that a lot of fabrics result in during the production process, and how some fabrics breathe better than others and are better for our skin. And you know how some clothes just start smelling really bad after a while? Yeah, the good old polyester devil. Linen would never. So these are some of the things that I've cleaned out of my closet the last year or so. A lot more has been donated. These are either things that I want to keep but that I'm just not using right now, or things that I'm being indecisive about. Here are some pieces that I've kept in my closet. I would say at least 95% of everything in here is made of natural fibers. Linen is my favorite. It's very durable and kind to both the skin and the environment, and that's what I'm looking for in most things. It does wrinkle quite a lot though, but I kind of like it. It makes you feel homey somehow. I love these plants. I love my books. Love this, got it in Spain. Love these organic cotton bags, I keep all sorts of things in them, I use one as my makeup bag. Love this razor, it will probably last me for many, many years. Yes ladies, you can even shave your goodies with a safety razor, just be careful. I don't really have much that I don't appreciate in my space at the moment, because I've either donated or sold pretty much everything that I didn't. And hopefully, whoever received those things can show them some more love than I could. Now, this isn't only about razors or clothes. It's really just about creating a life of things, people, and activities that you value and that you enjoy. Oh, and when it comes to people, make sure they value you just as much. That's equally important. And it's a continuing process of interesting reads, conversations, and experiences in the pursuit of learning more about how I can build my own ecosystem, my own little sustainable world inside of the one that we all live in. And that is just as much about eliminating toxic skincare products as it is eliminating toxic habits or people. I've talked about this before, that our lives aren't split into different parts that are completely independent of each other. Everything we do, how we behave, how we treat one certain area of our life, it mirrors itself elsewhere. That's why we like people who can take care of plants. It's an indicator that they care for other things in their life as well. Except I remember this one guy I dated. He was great with plants, not so great with anything else. Anyway, just create a life that you have appreciation for. One that makes you enjoy even the most mundane things. Start somewhere, anywhere. If that means air drying after showers, why not? Just mind your neighbors.